Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to show you a different method of how we can create mullions. So let's start by a circle. I want to go with circle by center points and I want to assign circles to the same center points which were the start point of the curtain panel boundaries. Assigning that to that, let's say I want to go with like circles with like 10 centimeters in diameter. In radius, which is going to be 20 centimeters in diameter. I'm going to run this. Now you see that a circle is created at each of the points, right? So if I like extrude this circle as solid, the difference is that extrude as surface is going to just create the four surfaces. If I go with solid, it's going to create a cap at the top and at the bottom as well. So that goes to curve, and this item goes to my height. I'm gonna run this, and now you see that for the mullions we have actually circular shapes over there, right? So let's make it a bit more interesting. How about we use some polygons inscribed in the circles? I'm gonna go with polygon. I'm gonna assign circle to circle. I'm gonna go with a integer slider going from a minimum of 3 to like a maximum of 16 for the number of sides. So this goes there, and then the polygon goes to curve. The distance stays the same, which is the height. I'm gonna run this, and now you see that we have actually triangular shapes for the mullion. Let me make this a bit larger. 0.2, run. And if I come here, you see that actually we have triangular mullions all over the curtain panels. You can work with different settings. You can change the size. You can go with four-sided, which is going to give us square-shaped mullions, six-sided, and so on. If you go with four-sided, you see that they are actually rotated, so we need to rotate them by 45 degrees. Now, I want to show you how you can randomize the size of the circles. So it's going to randomize the size of the polygons. Okay, let's keep this here. The thing that I need to change in order to have different sizes is the radius. So instead of one single number, I want to assign a list of random numbers. So I want to go with random. I'll go with random list, and I need one integer slider. And I'm gonna put the minimum value to the minimum value that we have, which is the number of mullions, which is 392. So the minimum is gonna be 392. I'm gonna change the maximum to 500. If I assign this to my amount, and if I run this, it's going to create 300 random numbers between 0 and 1. I can assign this to my radius, run. So now you see that, let's also put this on 3 first, for instance. Now you see that we have 392 mullions. Each of them has a different size based on the numbers which are created randomly, and they all have the same height. Okay, so it seems a little bit too big, so I want to do this. I want to go with A divided by like 2 or something. So let's say I want to divide this number by 2 and then assign it to the radius, run. This is now a bit more reasonable, right? So you can see how the facade works with mullions with different sizes. Okay, let's say I want to go with four-sided polygons, square-shaped, and the only thing here is that I need to rotate them by 45 degrees because now they're kind of actually rotated. Maybe this is what you want, but if it's not, simply you can do this. We can rotate the polygons. It's a geometry, so rotate geometry. Polygon goes to geometry. The origin of the rotations are the same points that we use to create the mullion. So point goes to origin If you hover the mouse around origin, you see that it's gonna accept points. So points goes to points. The axis is Z because we are going to rotate that around the Z axis. And the degrees in this case is 45 degrees. That goes to degrees. And the outcome of this goes to curves. So it's gonna be extruded. The rest is good. Now I'm gonna run this. Okay, now you see that they are rotated by 45 degrees. How about we try something else? Let's say it's gonna be like triangles or squares, doesn't matter. And we wanna just rotate them randomly, right? So we have a set of 392 random numbers. If I assign this to my degrees, because these numbers are between 0 and 1, they're gonna be too small. Random numbers generated in Dynamo are only between 0 and 1. If you want to have like larger values, we have to multiply that. So bring a code block, A times like 1000 or something. So they're at least 1000 times larger. And that goes to my degrees. I want to run this. Now these are the values which make more sense, 948 degrees, 73 degrees, and so on. And now you see that each of those triangles are rotating by a random number. Okay, you can go with four-sided, try that, or six-sided or something. All right, so this is a different thing you can do. You can also use like an attractor point to adjust the size. Let me group these items as cuboids method 2, or actually it's not cuboids anymore, this is actually polygons. This is our method 2 to creating shadings or mullions, so method 2. And the last step I want to do is that I want to not go with random numbers. So I don't want this last part. But I want to assign a set of numbers which are actually related to an attractor point. Also, I don't want to rotate that by a random number. I'm just gonna put 45 in this code block. Okay, now I'm gonna assign a number based on attractor point. So I'm gonna consider a point. Let's say the point is at 50 by 50 by 50 or something. This could be the location of the sun on the sky or something like that. I'm gonna run this. Let me go with 20 by 20 by 20. See if I can find a point here. Okay, there we go. So that's the point. How about I go with like 40 by 40 by 40? Okay, that's better. I can also change the Z, for instance. The Z can be like 80. Those other two can stay in 40. And that's the location of that point right now. Okay, so this is what I'm gonna do. This is my attractor point. I'm gonna group this as attractor point. And I want to get the distance between each of the points and the attractor point. You know the points are the ones which we got from the boundaries of the curtain panels. So points go to geometry, point goes to other. And if I run this, this is gonna give me the distance between that point and each of the points, right? So now if I assign this, for instance, directly to the radius of the circles that we had and run this, it's gonna give me like very huge amount of numbers because the distance is like 97, 89, etc., etc. So maybe I could divide those numbers by like a large value such as 50, and that goes to A, this goes to my radius. I'm gonna run this again. The numbers are still too big. Okay, I want to go with divide that by 100. Let's see how it works. Getting a little bit better. Let me go with 120. You can also use a number slider for that. You see that this side of the building, which is closer to that hypothetical point, they have smaller cuboids. That side has larger cuboids. I can change this number to a higher number, so the size of the mullions are going to be smaller. Maybe even more. I'm going to go with 200. Run. Okay, so now you see it's kind of a little bit more obvious. So this side the mullions are smaller, this side they are bigger. If we also change the location of that point, it's going to be more obvious what's going on. If I change this to like 20, change this to like 50, run this again, now the point is going to be closer. The point is over there now, right? And then you see that the mullions which are closer to the point, they're smaller. The ones which are on the other side, which are a bit further away, they are bigger. Okay, so this is another method of how to use an attractor point to create mullions in Dynamo. Finally, when you want to import them into Revit, you can use the same method. You can flatten the final solids. There are 392 solids here. If I flatten them and run this, it's gonna flatten those 392. Now I can directly assign to geometries, or let me show you one more trick. If you go with union, solid by union, it's gonna turn all those 392 objects or whatever you have into one single solid element. Okay, so in this case, if you take it to Revit, because they are all imported as one single element, they are not editable, right? Because they are all one, but it's gonna be easier to work with them because all of them is exported as one single solid. I'm gonna run this, and if we go to Revit, if I go to manage object styles, imported objects, you see that all those mullions are imported as one single element.